Hey Shopify store owners, in this video, Justin will be showing you how to set up ad extensions for your Shopify store Google AdWords campaigns.
Hi, this is Justin from OSI Affiliate Software. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to set up ad extensions for your AdWords campaigns. So first, I want to show you what exactly an ad extension is. So if I search for something such as iPad, usually you're going to get some sponsored results, and you can tell they're sponsored because they have this little ad button right here and they are above this little fold. But what's special about these is their extensions. So on here, there's actually four different links to see specific pages on Apple's store. There's even a link right here to one of the nearby stores, as well as a phone number. You're not going to find this on every advertisement because not every Google ad uses extensions. Now, the cool thing about extensions is it's actually free to add to your advertisements. And for an e-commerce store, there are some very useful extensions that you can take advantage of. So I'm going to show you two ways to activate them. First of all, I'm going to show you how to create a new campaign with these extensions. What you're going to do is sign into your Google AdWords account. Go over here to campaign, and we're just going to do search network with display select. You can of course change this to whatever you would like, but what really matters here is that instead of selecting standard, you activate all features. That will allow you to add extensions later. So let's go back. I've actually got a sample campaign already set up for my standard sneakers commerce store. So what we're going to do is once we have opened it up, we're going to go over here to add extensions. Okay, so now that I'm looking at my add extensions tab, I'm going to select which extension I want. So there are a few I can do. This first one, site links extension, will allow me to add links just like you saw with these first two. As you can see, there's links to different places on their respective websites. There's also location, which you saw on the first one where it has a specific address. If I click on that, it will show me it on Google Maps so I know how to get there. There's also one for calls, so you can show them your phone number easily. There's also one to show the user your app and provide a download link. A review extension will actually show a short review from a different website as well as provide a link to that review so that other customers can see what people are saying about your service and about your products. So if you're an e-commerce store, location extension probably isn't that important to you. Call extensions, you know, you might be using that, but for this video, I'm going to focus on site links, app, and review extensions. So let's go ahead and create a site links extension. What you need to do is select it and click the extension button. As you can see, I haven't made any site links, so I'm going to hit the plus button, and all I need to do is insert my link text. So I could do something like, running shoes. And now what I can do is provide a link to this specific page that shows all of my running shoes. You can also select whether or not you want this to be on mobile. I want it to be. And you can add a short optional description. Once you've done that, you need to make at least four, and you can make more if you would like. And you will need to select them for this campaign. Okay, so next we're going to make an app extension. So once you've selected it, you're going to hit the plus extension button again, and we're going to add our app. So you can choose either Android or iOS. They do not support other app stores such as Amazon or Microsoft's App Store. So we can select, for instance, iOS, and we can look up the app just by searching for the app name. Now, I don't have an app, so I can't really show you. You can also add link text. So you could say, you could add something like standard sneakers on iOS or standard sneakers iPhone app, something like that. And then you will add the URL. Also, I would recommend choosing mobile because you are promoting a mobile app. So definitely check that box. And once you've done all that, you'll just click save. Okay, now last but not least, review extensions. This is a great way for people to see what kind of business you are operating and what other people think of your website. This is a great way to add credibility. So I'm going to hit the plus button once again. and we're going to select a new review. Whether you choose paraphrase or exact quote really depends on how long the quote is. So I'm going to do paraphrase right now because I'm actually making up my own review. Now, of course, you don't want to make up a review. These need to be real because people might actually check, and because it's really just the right thing to do. So for source, you're going to name the source, not the link. So you could say, I'm actually just going to say myself because that's who gave the review, and then you'll put in your URL. Now, whenever you insert the source URL, make sure you are linking to the specific page where this paraphrased or exact quote can be found, not just the homepage. And of course, once you've done that, you're just going to click save. You can add as many reviews as you would like, and adding more may help you out, as certain reviews will be shown to different people. But that is all for extensions. Like I said earlier, there are two other extensions that you can take advantage of. However, I don't think they really apply as much to e-commerce stores. However, you are welcome to try them out. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Justin from OSI Affiliate Software. Thank you so much for watching, and be sure to check out our other videos about e-commerce marketing.